Tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats. Look ream, smell ream, be ream, it's Joey Essex. New kid on the block, it's Joe Lycett. And their team captain, Sean Lock. And facing them tonight, Vegas baby, it's Johnny Vegas. The queen of Hollyoaks, it's Jennifer Metcalfe. And their team captain, John Richardson. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello, and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats, a show about opinion polls, surveys and statistics. Did you know, for example, pensioners can save £3 a day by not putting on their heating, which over the rest of their lifetime could save them a whopping £9? 66% of men are superstitious. I have a few superstitions. I'm scared of cats, and I hate the numbers 8 and 10. But fortunately, it doesn't really affect my life. And 8% of people have had their wallet stolen in the last 5 years. When someone stole my wallet, I was devastated. I'd had that condom since I was 14. Right, let's get started. What are you talking about? That's the name of our first round. It's our panellists' job to guess the British public's top three most popular talking points. Sean, your team to go first. What do you think the nation have been talking about this week?
The Italian Prime Minister, Silvio Berlusconi.
Michael Jackson.
What, sorry?
Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
Well, let's stick on one thing, shall we, for a minute? Sean had a guess there and he was probably right, wasn't he? So let's...
We can talk about Michael Jackson if you want. I'm happy to do it if you want Michael Jackson to be our answer.
Well, what do you think the nation should be talking about Joey Essex?
Michael Jackson.
What have you been saying about Michael Jackson this week?
I don't know. I don't know whether it's true about him. Like, you know about the whole thing where did the doctor mean to kill him?
Yeah, what do you think?
I don't know.
Well, it's been...
Well, it's been fascinating talking to you, Joey.
Well, the accusation was that he was negligent. You know, he gave him too much propofol. I don't know. I've had scrumpy that's stronger than that stuff.
Michael Jackson got confused because he was used to doling out in children's portions.
Yeah. Yeah. Profixilix.
Profixilix.
Profixilix, the kids' one.
Mmm, drowsy.
Yeah. He ordered 4 gallons of it. Four gallons. He must have had it on draft. Probably the reason Michael Jackson died is he was changing the barrel. Lovely head on that.
This doctor was getting paid £96,000 a month.
Really?
Yeah, to look after. And that alone, you would go, yeah, convict.
Yeah.
Clearly something wrong
there. Do you think he still got paid? He only lasted 10 days. You know, I mean, Gaza would have lasted longer as his doctor.
I think if that doctor were getting nearly 100 grand a month, why didn't he get a year out of him?
Yeah.
That's what makes me think he didn't do it.
That's a twisted logic there. It's almost like that doctor was motivated to keep him alive.
Yeah.
That's incredible. He's on £96,000 a month, and when they found Jackson, his first words were, "Does anyone know CPR?"
Yeah.
Yeah, you, hopefully.
Isn't a question of guilt about whether he was really paying attention to Michael? Jackson, and he'd given him the propofol, and then he went downstairs to another room, and he had a baby listener. That's what I found. That's the really spooky thing about it. And he must have been sitting there, like watching Downton Abbey or whatever, and he could just hear Michael Jackson going,
"Can I have some milk? can I have some more milk?"
And he'd be going, "Michael, go to bed. If I have to come up there." You won't be going on that holiday to the O2.
Some more milk.
He said that Conrad Murray was his closest friend as well, which is a bit odd, isn't it? You can imagine Bubbles the monkey sat in a sanctuary going, "He said I was his BFF."
I've got a rumour that he's actually still alive.
Yeah,
Joey. He's still...
That's what I've heard.
Is he still alive?
He's on some random, like, desert island somewhere, just...
Well, yeah. He's on a random desert...
That's not a rumour. That's a load of bollocks.
Oh, well, let's have a look and see whether Michael Jackson is one of the most talked about things this week. Yes, Dr. Conrad Murray has been found guilty of the manslaughter of Michael Jackson. The Jackson family told the prosecutor they'd not just lost a pop icon, but a son and a brother and a valuable source of income. OK, John Steen, what else will the nation be talking about this week?
I don't know, I think maybe Berlusconi. Just get the impression it's been on the tip of people's tongue.
Don't you wish you'd thought of that?
Yeah.
So go on, Berlusconi.
The Italian pervert. Weird.
Prime Minister, I think, is there. Good old Silvio. He's worth $9 billion. And he's in charge of a country which has the third biggest debt in the world. Well, that's no surprise. How can you explain to Silvio we're in bad debt? No, I'm not. No, you're not, but we are. No, I'm fine. Yeah. But he's gone now, so it's all going to be fine.
Dead? He's not dead.
He's not dead. No, he's...
I know you work in Hollyoaks and people tend to die. he's just lost his job.
Oh, that's fine. Is he good looking?
He's a sexy 74-year-old.
We've got a still of him. I can show you a picture of him. Have a little look.
That's all right.
That's all right. You would? I like the guy in the background thinking, is he chatting to my wife? He looks really worried, like he's just lost his wife.
Apparently it's 10 grand a night.
Really?
Would you do that for 10 grand?
For me to be him?
No. Yeah.
No, you can't ask someone if they turn themselves into a prostitute.
Would you prostitute yourself?
I'd do it for five. Five's fine.
Yeah, but his, oh, his like
four.
Defense.
Four. I'd do it for four. Four.
I'd do it for the lift home.
I wish I had another woman on here. I don't think I can take you all on by myself.
This isn't a bunga bunga party.
Did you just say that out loud? Am I sleeping now?
It's all right. I've got a lot of feminine traits and I'm very metrosexual. I'm sorry, I will involve you more. Jesus Christ, you come on a panel show, it's like a relationship!
Let's see if Silvio Berlusconi is one of the top three talking points. Yes, it is. The Eurozone crisis has left Italian leader Silvio Berlusconi in an awkward position, attempting to maintain an erection while talking on the phone to Angela Merkel. Right, fingers on buzzers, one more thing to go.
Well, it's Frankie Kokoza, isn't it? After so much abuse, he's finally gone.
Thank God.
I liked him.
I just can't sing. I mean, I cannot hold a tune, but he cannot sing.
He couldn't sing, but he was on X Factor. I'm not sure whether that really matters.
Yeah, and I'm sure he's not the first one to do cocaine as well on there.
What? When he's saying cocaine, it's called the Golden Rule. That's what it is now. He's done a big line of the Golden Rule.
They said he broke the Golden Rule. And they also said in the papers, they said that he spent the money he got from the M&S advert on cocaine, presumably not just any cocaine. From their ready-to-snort range.
He's already done an M&S advert.
Yeah, they got all of the X Factor people to be in the advert, and then they take them out one by one from the advert as they get close to Christmas. And we've worked hard to get where we are. We're not in the M&S Christmas ad.
I was going to say, I swear to God, right, everything I'm wearing tonight is M&S Blue Arbor. It's not even, you know, from the exclusive range. And they won't return my calls.
How did he get so far anyway?
Girls
must have loved him.
It's the bad boy.
He couldn't sing, he didn't have any discernible talent, and yet he seemed to be a big star.
He's still got
Joey Essex.
It should be some kind of...
Surprisingly, that's not one of our top three talking points. The other big news in X Factor this week is that Johnny is out. No shit, Sherlock.
And I love the cock.
When they say Craig Coulton could be bigger than Subo, they're not just talking about his singing career. Hey, even if he does get kicked out, it's not the last we'll see of him on TV. There's always embarrassing bodies. Or inside nature's giants. As I go, fingers on buzzers, one more thing to get.
Is it the FIFA poppy scandal?
FIFA said that they weren't allowed to wear poppies, the England
Because
team.
They said it was a political statement. Mm.
Some people would find the three lions offensive. You know, for example, if you got drunk and climbed into a zoo. That reminds me of Uncle Terry. He got eaten by lions and you're wearing them on your shirt. Have you got no feelings?
Papers kept saying, oh, Prince William has saved the day. They weren't going to let us wear poppies. And then Prince, where there's a wills, there's a way. As if he found out about it, we're ready my horse. And then he charged to Sepp Blatter's house and said, I challenge you to a duel, sir. Rather than the truth, which was someone else drafted an email and went, do you mind if we send this with your name on it? He went, yes, I suppose so. This image that John Terry finally wants to show what a patriot he is, he's been doing that for years. No one's in doubt that John Terry's proud to be English. The fact is, he's also a wanker.
Jennifer, do you know any footballers?
No, I don't really watch it.
You don't really watch it?
I knew one once.
I read
you knew one once? Who did you know once?
Ooh, don't talk about him.
Hollyoaks was like, I always thought Hollyoaks was like a shopping channel for footballers.
How do you talk about football? Do you know Joey Barton?
What, sorry?
Joey Barton.
Do I know Joey Barton?
Do you know him?
I know of Joey Barton.
QPR footballer.
Yeah, he's a footballer
for QPR. He had to go at you, didn't he?
Quite offensive to him. Yeah, Essex. I think he's jealous. Jill. Mate, he's totes Jill, man.
He's totes Jill of Towie. I'm enjoying saying that. I don't understand any of those words. What happened with Joey Barton? What did he say about you?
I'm not really sure. He basically just like, he was trying to mug a few people off, saying...
He was mugging people off?
Yeah.
What does that mean? He was...
Knocking their tea.
Yeah. Oh. Basically, we went to a premiere, and I think he saw a few people there. So afterwards, he decided to tweet just saying, Towie freaks, weirdos, things like that.
He called you a freak and a weirdo?
He called me a freak and a weirdo. I was well offended.
That's not nice, is it?
But he was tweeting at half one in the morning, so stop tweeting, go to bed, man, on your ice cream.
Yeah, Joey Barton, what are you doing up at half one? You should be in bed, you're really naughty. Joey Barton did say some very unkind things about the Only Way Is Essex recently, and I think it's only fair that you have the right to reply. Let's have a look at you in action on the Only Way Is Essex.
What's your favourite animal?
I want to say a cat, but it's boring, but it's cat. I love cats. I like cat thighs. What about you?
Oh, mine's an elephant.
Why elephant?
I don't know. It's like, they're weird, aren't they? They've got them big long things, like... I would say dinosaur, but they don't exist anymore, do they? So.
Sorry, Joey Barton's seen that and he's calling you an idiot.
You could have got on with Johnny?
I couldn't get away with that. Look, I get nervous in front of women. You, the banter just rolls out. You know, I'm stuck for words. I can't even think of animals. My favourite animal is a train!
It's not one of the greatest. In the sort of pantheon, in the list of great chat-up lines, what's your favourite animal? I don't think it's ever really sort of been a clincher, has it?
Do you want a better chat-up line? Did you fall from heaven? Because it looks like you landed on your face.
My personal favourite. Does anyone know you're here?
OK, let's have a look and see whether the FIFA poppy scandal is one of the most talked about things this week. Yes, this is the story that FIFA tried to ban poppies being worn by the England team. FIFA relented after Prince William wrote them a strongly worded letter. Oh, please let us wear poppies or I'll be really sad. I'm going bald and I married the wrong sister. So at the end of that round, Sean, Joe and Joey have 2 points. Johnny, Jennifer and John have one. That's it for part one. See you after the break. Welcome back to 8 out of 10 Cats. Our next round is pick of the polls. Sean, Joe, Joey, what do you like the look of?
The waxing.
OK, all right, so here's your related question. Most men are too embarrassed to undergo beauty treatments. True or false?
Well, you've undergone a few, or is that a natural tan?
This is natural.
Oh,
that's a natural tan, is it?
I've had sunbeds, but I've quit sunbeds now. I don't have sunbeds no more. So
you've quit sunbeds?
Quit.
My God, oh. You've made some sacrifices, haven't you? When did you quit sunbeds?
Last week.
So, what's your daily regime, beauty-wise? What do you do, beauty-wise?
Obviously, you know, I wake up, look at myself, and I think, Reem. But then I get, then what? Then I get in the shower, do my hair afterwards, bang, bang. What are you saying?
Bang, bang, and who's over there?
That was meant to be the mirror.
Oh, I thought that was your carer. Jennifer, you're a lady now. Do you think men are too pampered these days? Do we do too much?
Yeah, I do. I like men like hairy, smelly.
Johnny Vegas. John, do you do any?
No, I wouldn't say I'm too embarrassed. I just think the prettier you are, the more you're going to disappoint someone at some point, because they'll think, oh, that's the one, and then you go,
So you say you don't do anything, you don't do any beauty treatments?
I had my first extraneous nostril hair this week.
It's terrible, isn't it?
Yeah, it was the first one. I was driving and I just checked my rearview mirror and it was there.
Hello!
And that was the first vanity issue I've had of, like, well, that needs sorting, and there's no reason I shouldn't have just let them all come out.
How'd you get it out?
No.
I just pulled and I pulled until I cried.
When you get to boots and buy your first nasal trimmer, the way the girl looks at you, you know, and she slides it across with the beep.
I don't know, Johnny.
What, and you can't look away, because if you look away, you give them a better angle.
Sure. Beauty treatments.
I have had waxing, but I won't take my trousers off. They have to do it keyhole.
Joey, you take very good care of your hair, I've noticed.
Yeah.
Have a little look at this.
I didn't know you blow dried your hair.
I don't blow dry my hair.
You just blow dried it.
No, I'm hair dry my hair.
That is a blow dry.
No, I blow dry when you go to a shop, innit? Like, if you go to a shop, you get your hair blow dried. You're a girl, go to a salon.
It's not. If you blow dry your hair, you blow dry your hair. It's the same, whether you do it or someone else does it.
Yeah, but no, you've got to put one. I'm so confused.
Do you do that every day? Do you have to blow dry your hair every day?
Yeah, but I don't. This is not a blow dryer. This is a hair dryer.
Yeah, exactly the same thing.
So what do you think?
I'm going to get you a diffuser.
A what?
And then you can't technically say, even that's another step away from blow drying.
A diffuser?
Yeah, it's one, you know, with the little spikes in there, you just run it through. What it does, it breaks it up and you'll get no split ends.
What have you done with a real Johnny Vegas?
Johnny, what do you use on your hair?
Hey, sunshine, I had a perm, all right, that, 2 minutes. I used to lacquer, I used a mousse, I used a diffuser. Didn't towel dry, because that created heat and friction. No, I'm wrapped round, I give it 20 good minutes. I treated it with respect. I hope that shit falls out.
I didn't mean offence to that, man.
Yeah, well, you did. And I'm, you know what? Give out for that. Look after it. You don't know where you go while you're young.
OK. So most men are too embarrassed to undergo beauty treatments.
I'm going bald! Look at that.
That's not that bad.
No.
I'm worse than that. Mind you, I think that's because I have very vivid dreams.
Okay, so most men are too embarrassed to undergo beauty treatments. True or false? What are you going to say, Sean?
True.
You think it's true? You think they are too embarrassed?
Yes,
Sean,
I do,
what do you
yes.
think?
Team?
Jennifer, what do you think? False. Are most men false. Too embarrassed?
False.
You're going to go false. Okay. I can tell you the answer is false. Oh. You got it. Yes. Yes, only 43% of men said they'd be too embarrassed to have beauty treatments. These days, you can even get your arsehole bleached. That's what Liz Hurley did with Shane Warne. And the winner is the name of our final round. Here is your question. Top thing British people lie about.
I think most people lie about any sentence that starts, I know a lovely place. Like when you go for dinner or to a pub and they go, oh, I know a great little place. And it's miles away and it's shit. How was that your anecdote? I know a great place and it stinks and the food's crap. So now I hate the place and you for liking it.
It's telling your partner or your wife that they're your best friend. That's a lie. That's a lie. That's such a lie, isn't it? Because if you don't go out for 14 pints with your wife, do you? You don't say to your wife, let's go and have 14 pints. Because you do with a best friend, don't you? Go, let's go and have 14 pints.
Why for when?
Funny number.
I lie about drinking quite a lot. Like, I'll say, I only had 3 glasses of wine, and then I'll go, oh, no, I did have another 3 glasses of wine. And then I did kick a toddler in the face. It's a worry.
I lied about Christine Brinkley. I say I saw Christine Brinkley. She was modelling flippers on the Albert Bridge. I see her at all. I say, you know Christine Brinkley?
Yeah.
She used to be my taekwondo teacher.
Yeah.
You know, I go, no, Christine Blakely, I bought her a she'd be on the telly, and I go, see that woman there, Christine Blakely? Years ago, I bought a reconditioned Flymo off her.
Sorry, is that true or not true? Did you buy a reconditioned Flymo off?
No, just make it up for a bit of fun. Just make up
you
all
just
these,
saw it.
All yeah, these stories about Christine Blakely. And you know the canoe man? He hid in her loft for a year.
Do you know Christine Blakely, yeah?
I do actually know Christine Blakely. Well, she's a nice
yeah.
woman.
Yeah, she's not. I make up lies about her.
John, what do you lie about?
Everything, constantly. I lie about people's names. Like, if the first thing you had to do when you saw someone was say their name, people who've known me for years would find out that, actually, I don't really care who they are. I don't think anyone really knows anyone's name.
Do you know what? I call everyone, yeah? If I don't know someone's name, for some reason, I call them Ashley.
That's good, because a lot of us have been just calling them mate or pal or all right, fella.
For some reason,
but Ashley's much better because it's because if it is Ashley, quid's in.
Is it age? Do people lie about age?
Oh, that is that age is number two on the list.
Is it their weight?
It's not worth lying about. Genuinely, people know I'm not 9 stone. I've regularly.
It's to do with partners.
Sexual partners.
That was the right answer.
You did that at the beginning.
Yes, the top thing British people lie about is the number of sexual conquests they've had. I've rounded mine up to 2. Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are John, Johnny and Jennifer have 3 points. Sean, Joe and Joey have 2, which means John, Jennifer and Johnny are tonight's winners. To all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.